Consumer Theory Explained. Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today, we're diving into one of the foundational concepts of microeconomics that you'll encounter in every serious econ course, consumer theory, also known as consumer choice theory. This topic sits at the core of how economists model individual behavior and demand in markets. If you've ever wondered how we decide what to buy, or how economists turn those choices into equations, this is the video for you. Whether you're a bachelor's student prepping for exams, or a master's student brushing up your knowledge, we're going deep but keeping it accessible. Let's start with the basics. Consumer theory is the study of how people decide to spend their money based on their preferences and their income. Imagine you've got a budget, say $50. You can spend that money on pizza, coffee, or streaming subscriptions. How do you allocate that budget to get the most satisfaction? That satisfaction is what we call utility. So, the central question in consumer theory is, how can a consumer maximize their utility given their budget constraint? And to model this behavior, economists make a few key assumptions. Let's walk through them. First up, rationality. Economists assume consumers are rational, meaning they make decisions aimed at maximizing their utility. You might be thinking, wait, I don't always make the best decisions. And you're not alone. We'll come back to this in a moment. Assumption two, consistency of preferences. If you prefer apples to oranges today, you'll still prefer them tomorrow. Your preferences don't randomly change. Assumption three, diminishing marginal utility. This one's key. The more of a good you consume, the less additional satisfaction you get from each extra unit. The first slice of pizza? Amazing. The tenth? Meh. Then there are some more technical assumptions we use to simplify the math. Perfect information. We assume that consumers know everything about the products they're choosing from. Price-taking behavior. We assume that consumers accept market prices and don't bargain. Linear prices. We assume that every unit of a good costs the same. Divisible goods. We assume you can buy fractional units of any good, like 2.5 pairs of jeans or 0.3 of a book. Obviously unrealistic, but super helpful for building smooth mathematical models. Now, these assumptions might seem unrealistic, and that's okay. They're tools, not rules. They help us build models that are mathematically feasible and still provide useful insights. Let's get into the heart of consumer theory, utility maximization. Imagine a student named Alex with a weekly budget of $100 to spend on oranges and apples. If Alex is getting more utility per dollar from oranges than apples, they should shift spending toward oranges until the utility per dollar is equal across both goods. This is known as the equal marginal principle, and it's where the marginal rate of substitution, MRS, equals the price ratio. At this point, Alex has optimized their consumption. Any further reallocation would actually lower their utility. Now, in models, we often represent utility with a utility function, something like where U is utility and X and Y are quantities of two goods. To find the optimal consumption bundle, we usually solve a constraint optimization problem using the Lagrangian method. You might remember this from class. We set up this Lagrangian function, L, is set equal to Alex's utility function, U, plus lambda times Alex's budget constraint. The budget constraint is 100. Alex's budget minus the prices times the quantities of the goods, X and Y, that Alex could buy. Take partial derivatives, solve the first order conditions, and boom, you've got the utility maximizing quantities for X and Y. So, what happens when we scale this up? Say we model Alex's orange consumption using their utility function and budget. We can now ask, how many oranges will Alex buy at different prices? That gives us Alex's individual demand curve. Now, repeat this for everyone in the market, from Alex to Zara to Jordan, and sum their individual demands. What do you get? The market demand curve for oranges. This is one of the most powerful applications of consumer theory, linking individual utility-maximizing behavior to aggregate the market outcomes. It's how microeconomics connects the personal to the macro-level trends. Now, let's zoom out. What if consumers aren't rational? What if they don't have perfect information or their preferences change day to day? Enter behavioral economics, a field that brings in insights from psychology to question and refine the assumptions of classical consumer theory. For instance, people tend to overemphasize losses compared to gains. People often suffer from decision fatigue and default bias. People rarely have perfect information. These insights don't invalidate classical consumer theory. They extend it. They help us build richer models that explain real-world behavior more accurately. So, there you have it. Consumer theory in a nutshell, from utility maximization under constraints to market demand curves and even extension of our models with behavioral economics, consumer theory is essential to understanding how microeconomic models work. If you're studying for exams, focus on the key assumptions, how to solve utility maximization problems, and how individual behavior connects to market demand. Let us know in the comments if you want a full walkthrough of a Lagrangian optimization problem, or if you're curious about behavioral economics models. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share with your fellow econ nerds. Thanks for watching, and as always, stay rational, or at least try to.